Tonight on the Studio Review, we've got a surprising cover, a new Ode To, and my greatest accomplishment so far this year. 3 segments, 5 minutes. Here we go.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the Studio Review with your host, Sam Reid.
Welcome back to the Studio Review. For this first segment, we're taking things way back to 2005 for a new take on an old favorite. Enjoy. As always, don't forget to let me know if you have song requests, and while you're at it, you can click subscribe and like this video. Those may seem like small things, but they go a really long way in helping this channel. Next up, I dip my toes into podcasting for a new installment of An Ode To. This morning, I found the most heinous of crime scenes. Someone had finished the milk and put the empty gallon back in the fridge. There was only one question on my mind. Who killed this milk? I shot off a quick text to my wife, who was upstairs. No response. I knew I had to get to the bottom of this. The police would be no help because they take money from Big Dairy. This time, I was on my own. I started where anyone would start, at the source. I went to the grocery store where the milk was purchased, but it seemed like no one wanted to talk. It was almost as if they were all hiding something. But what? Could it be a deadly secret? This murder podcast is brought to you by SpaghettiOs. Visit SpaghettiOs.com/murder for 10% off your first order. That's M-U-R-D-E-R. Just like the milk, my trail had gone cold. It was time to hire a private investigator.
Hello.
Hi, yes, I'm wondering if you can help me place someone at the scene of a crime.
Hey, what do you mean?
Well, I've just heard that you can, like, triangulate someone's position by using pings from cell phone towers.
Yeah, that's not really what a private investigator does.
Another dead end. Oh, my wife just responded. And then I remembered, it was me. After all these years of listening to amateurs investigate murders, you just never expect the culprit to be you. Case closed. And finally, it's time for a brand new segment where I become the first person to achieve something. This is firsts. What's up and welcome to First. So they just tore down this building in my town and then rebuilt this beautiful strip mall with a brand new Dunkin' Donuts. And I'm trying to be the first customer there. I went in there today and I asked them when they'd be opening and they said, we don't know. I said, do you have a ballpark idea? And they said, hopefully some point tomorrow. So I'm gonna try to come back tomorrow. Okay, it's 6 a.m. I'm gonna go scope it out. Looks pretty dead to me. We'll check back later. All right, I'm back. We're just gonna stake it out. All right, I got about 30 minutes into my stakeout and I heard this guy mention that Monday is now the new opening date. So we're gonna try again on Monday. Okay, it's like 5:20 a.m. on Monday. I still don't know what time the store is opening, but I'm gonna go check it out. Okay, not a single car in the parking lot. So I'm gonna go to the gym and come back in a little bit. This location's like not even in the Dunkin' app. There are no signs at the store, nothing. It's all just guesswork. All right, it's a little after 6:30, still no signs of life. Okay, I think these are the first employees of the day walking in just before 8 a.m. You guys are never gonna believe this. So I went up to the door and they're like, no, we're not open, go away. But I was able to ask them what time they're gonna open and they're like, not till tomorrow. We're still waiting on some permits. I asked, do you know what time tomorrow? And they said no. So I'm starting to think this is all an elaborate ruse. This is not a real Dunkin' Donuts. Okay, it's now Tuesday. It's about 5:30 a.m. and I'm heading to Dunkin' for like the third time. This is just becoming a part of who I am now, but I'm optimistic. I think today's gonna be the day. Okay, I think it opens at 6:00. So right now I'm just staking out the drive-thru to make sure nobody gets there ahead of me. All right, 5:59, here we go.
Hi, good morning. Welcome to Dunkin'. How can I help you?
Hi. Could I get a Boston cream pie donut and the Charlie?
Would you like another donut today for a dollar?
Oh my gosh. Sure.
All right. You can drive right up. Sorry. It's our first day opening.
No worries. Am I your first customer?
You are.
Wow. It's an honor.
I'm like the mayor of Dunkin'.
Thank you so much. Number one customer at Dunkin', the sweet taste of victory. I just want to say never give up on a dream because of the time that it'll take, because the time is going to pass anyway. And, you know, reach for the stars. You can achieve anything you set your mind to. Never stop dreaming. Okay, that's it. It's so good. Shout out Charlie D'Amelio, 203 represent. Hey, before you go, May is Mental Health Awareness Month, so I'd love to invite you to maybe learn a little bit more for yourself or help break the stigma for someone else, because mental health is just as important as our physical health. But that wraps it up for episode 10. Thank you so much for watching. Episode 11 will come out next Saturday, so make sure you're subscribed so you don't miss out. And just remember that even when it doesn't feel like it, it's gonna be okay. I'll see you soon.